everybody. My name is Alita, and I am delighted to have you here at my science lab today. So today we're going to be doing some fun hands-on activities, and you should hopefully have one of our Science Starz kits with you. But first of all, what is science? What do you think of when you hear the word science? Do you think potions? Explosions? Yes, those are all things that have to do with science. However, science is so much more than that. You are probably doing a bit of science each and every day, and you don't even realize it. For example, have you ever wondered how things work? Do you ever ask questions? Do you like to investigate? Have you ever wondered why some leaves change color in the autumn and fall to the ground? Have you ever wondered why the sky is blue? Have you ever wondered why when you throw a ball up in the air, it comes down? Well, if you have said yes to any of those things, you are already behaving like a scientist. So I hope that by doing these activities today, you're going to really enjoy it and that it's going to ignite an interest in science so that when you get older, you may go on to take up science in secondary or in university, and you might end up being a scientist yourself someday or be working in some sort of a science field. So today we're going to be making a bath bomb. And I bet you probably didn't think that a bath bomb has to do with science, but it very much does. It's a branch of science called chemistry, because the two ingredients here that make the bath bomb bubble are acids and alkalis, and when they come together, they create a chemical reaction, releasing all sorts of bubbles filled with carbon dioxide. So that is chemistry here in this little bubble. So let's get started. So we are going to be making a bath bomb, and let's open up our kit and see what's inside. So you should have a spray bottle with water, some sodium bicarbonate, citric acid, Epsom salts, oil, and a bobble. And that will close together and snap shut like so. Okay. You will also need a bowl to mix your ingredients and a spoon for scooping it into the bobble. So to start, take your sodium bicarbonate, or baking soda as some people call it, and empty it into your bowl. Okay. Then take your citric acid and you're going to pour it into the bowl as well. Just dump it all in. Okay, and then give it a good stir. Okay, so citric acid, based on its name, is an acid, and sodium bicarbonate is an alkali. And when they mix together with a liquid, they start to react. And that is what causes the fizzy bubbles in your bath bomb when you put it into the bathtub. Right now, I'm mixing them together, but they're not reacting because they are dry. Okay, so I've given it a good stir. And now I would like to add some oil, because that will make my skin nice and soft. Whoops. And give it a good squeeze, a generous squeeze. You don't need to use all of the bottle, but a good enough amount, and you'll know yourself if it still feels dry after mixing it up, you can add some more. Okay, so keep stirring. So at this point here, I have some gloves that I'm going to put on because I'm going to mix it with my hands. Now, it's safe to mix with your bare hands, but I just know it's a wee bit oily. So I'm going to use my gloves. So I'm going to mix it up really well. So the consistency that you want it to kind of hold together when you squish it, like so. Now what I want to do is add some water. Okay, so this is a little spray bottle. So what you want to do, you saw me take the lid off, you want to squirt some water into your bowl. And be careful not to squirt too much, because what will happen, remember I said when it comes into contact with water or liquid, it will start to react. So you want to be careful not to add too much, but you want to add some because that is going to help everything hold together. You might hear it starting to fizz because it will start to react. And what you'll be hearing is the chemical reaction that's taking place. So it's going to be fizzing and creating carbon dioxide bubbles. Okay, a few more squirts. And keep mixing. You just want to keep mixing the whole time so that the water gets spread throughout the whole mixture. Okay, so now I'm going to take my bauble, take one side of it, and I'm going to spray that with water as well. So, giving that a spray, and give that spray or two. And now it's time to add some color. Now these are Epsom salts, okay? These are generally used in the bath, but we're gonna put them into our bath bomb. So what I want to do is I want the color to be seen, so I'm gonna put it into the bauble first, like so. I'm just gonna mix it around a wee bit so that it covers the bauble so that I'll be able to see it. I'll put some more in here. You can put in as much as you'd like. You can put it all in if you'd like. I'm just going to put about that much. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to start to fill up my bauble with my mixture. Now, the important thing here is to squeeze it down nice and compact. Okay, the more compact that you make it, the easier it's going to be for it all to hold together and to keep its shape. As you can see, I've got my color. So I'm pressing it down. You can use your spoon or your fingers. So that's one side filled. And then take your other half of the bauble and start filling that one up as well. Okay, make sure it's full to the top, because when you bring the two halves together, this top bit has to connect with the other half for it to hold together. Okay, I think that's about all I can get in. All right. So now what you want to do, before we bring them together, we want to give them another spray or two, as that will help hold it together again. Okay. Give it a couple of squirts. Can you see it starting to react a little bit? Not to worry, there's still more there that can react or will react. So now bring them together carefully and try to squeeze it so it shuts. Okay? Now, be careful not to squeeze too hard because you might crack the bauble. And if it's not closing, you might have too much of the mixture. So just pull them apart again, remove a little bit, spray it again, and then close it. Okay? So there you go. There's your bath bomb. Now, you're going to want to leave it to dry for about a day or two. And then, after a day or two, you'll be able to take it out of your bauble and it will be nice and dry and ready for your bath. However, in some cases, your bath bomb might get stuck to your bauble and not come out very easily. So instead of forcing it and possibly damaging your bath bomb, if you can remove one side, just place the whole thing in your bathtub and then it will come off, as this will start to dissolve as soon as it hits the water. So a bath bomb is a lovely treat for nearly all of your senses because you've got your sense of touch being used, you've got your sense of smell because it'll have a lovely baby powder smell, you're using your sense of sight as you're watching it dissolve, and you've got your sense of hearing when you are listening to the bubbles fizzing when it starts to react. The only sense that you should not use is your sense of taste. So please do not put these in your mouth. But other than that, enjoy your bath bomb and enjoy your bath.